In 2010, we first gathered in Brussels, a group of people representing Christian Democrats, conservative, and like-minded foundations and think tanks from both sides of the Atlantic. At that first meeting, we discussed key global developments and our bilateral relations from a center-right perspective. The value of that dialogue quickly became apparent. Last year in Washington, we continued the discussion for the second year in a row. And today, it is my pleasure to come together for the third time with the International Republican Institute for what I hope will be a fruitful continuation of our dialogue and collaboration. I thank really Lorne Craner. He is the president of International Republican Institute, and I remember very well the beginning of our cooperation. It was a very important step for our EPP political family, unusual step because all European parties and think tanks were working together with NDI, and we were consequent and logical, and we wanted with enthusiasm to have this contact and this cooperation with IRI and also with our friends from the Republican Party. Let me also express my appreciation to our American friends for traveling here to Brussels and for taking the time to join us in the middle of a crucial election year. The US presidential contest will determine a lot not only for America, but also for Europe. Indeed, the United States and the European Union are closely linked, and what happens to one has an impact on the other. We are each other's most important trade and investment partners. Our people have strong historical and cultural ties, and we both build our societies on the same core values of democracy and the rule of law. And yet, even with the many commonalities shared by Europe and the US throughout history, now is perhaps a time in which our political and policy goals are more aligned than ever. Right now, the conversations in Brussels and Washington are remarkably similar. People on both sides of the Atlantic are feeling the effects of the last 4 years of economic hardship, and policymakers on both sides are increasingly called upon to boost job growth. Both Americans and Europeans are worried about their current and future livelihoods in an ever-changing and increasingly complex world. And both America and Europe need to find a way to return to sustainable and meaningful economic growth. One thing that unites those of us in this room today is the belief that many of these common challenges can be addressed through a stronger transatlantic economic relationship. Whilst trade and investment flows between Europe and the US already constitute the world's largest economic relationship, what is needed now is a breakthrough to the next level of cooperation. That will be the subject of the first discussion this afternoon, which will focus on a potential US-EU free trade agreement, including the economic benefits as well as political obstacles associated with such a deal. After lunch, the discussion will turn to transatlantic cooperation in a changing world, especially in the context of the rise of China and other emerging economic powers. Under President Obama, the United States has begun to focus increasingly on the Pacific region, which some say has been to the detriment of the transatlantic relationship. We will discuss this theme whilst also seeking to identify possibilities for developing a common approach for the European Union and the United States in order to address such global shifts. After all, our interests and concerns are the same on both sides of the Atlantic. And that leads me to one final point I would like to emphasize before we begin our discussions today. Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, the United States and the European Union have one characteristic in common, which may unite us more than anything. Both areas are comprised of many different and individual entities. States on one side of the Atlantic and countries on the other. And in both places, these entities, when taken together, are stronger than just the sum of their parts. Both the United States and European project prove the idea that we can accomplish more together than we can separately. Now more than ever, it is vital that we extend that basic concept to the transatlantic partnership. I believe firmly and wholeheartedly that the more united our approach is, whatever the challenge, the more we can accomplish. Thank you for your attention, and I would now like to give the floor to the President of the International Republican Institute, Lorne Kraler.